fantastic as well. So if you like to get your name in the raffle, maybe cut out for one of the tunes. I'm not sure, but we'll do that. We'll do that raffle after we play a few orchestra tunes, and then right before An American in Paris, we'll select who's going to win. Stan, if you'd like to come to the concert, band concert on Thursday, it's going to be at Granada High School. The other four stands will be raffled off. So we got eight made this trimester, which is great. It's absolutely phenomenal. We're looking forward to giving those four stands a happy home, and then having four more stands on Thursday as well. We're going to start with a piece called Revelation's Edge. It'll be a joke.
Thank you.
Cantabile by Tchaikovsky from his Symphony No. 5, Second Movement Cantabile.
Thank you.
this next piece is some film music. It's by Aaron Copland. It's called The Red Pony, which is based off of the book, which I believe is also called The Red Pony, by John Steinbeck. It's about a boy named Jody, and we're going to do four scenes from this book and also this movie. The first one is just morning at the ranch, happy time, going out and doing chores, I suppose, on the ranch. The second movement is, it's all together, but the second part is called The Dream March. Jody has this fantasy about his best friend, maybe more than friends, Billy Buck. And they have a dream that, he has a dream that they're both knights. And they go and they march together, and they're heroes together. And then there's a wonderful little park called Walk to the Bunkhouse, where they just finish riding horses all day, and Jody and his best friend Billy, they're going to go down to the bunkhouse have a nice time together. And then, of course, what's the story without happy ending? And then we're going to go back to the theme from the beginning, and very happily. This is The Red Pony by Aaron Copland.
Thank you.
next song is by Brian Balmond, one of my favorite modern composers. It's called Ice Sculptures. It's a story about, it's not really a story, but it's a piece about in Sweden and Norway, when it gets very cold, colder than we're used to in California, when it's sub-zero 24 hours a day, they make not only ice sculptures, but entire buildings made out of ice. Ice hotels. And so people actually stay at these ice hotels. So this next piece, called Ice Sculptures by Brian Balmond, you'll hear the ice sculptures being built, and then a nice, wonderful time celebrating this wonderful work of art that they've created that exists between December and April. And then April, of course, the sun comes up, and it becomes much warmer, and the ice that they've spent so long crafting and enjoying, it is, in the end, temporary. So it ends up melting in April. So this is a piece called Ice Sculptures. Feature our cello section, also has Hattie back there on the piano. Ice Sculptures. And if we could shut the doors, that would be great. This one's quiet. I imagine the car. Ruining the the orchestra wins. This one is the Brandenburg Concerto number 3. Number 3, Johann Sebastian Bach. He wrote a lot of music. He's the grandfather of all music, not just because he had over 20 kids, but he also, he did it, true story. But he wrote wonderful music before our country was founded in the early 1700s. This is his Brandenburg Concerto. And then we'll bring the orchestral winds on, and we'll play a piece by American composer George Gershwin called American Empire. But first, the Brandenburg Concerto, arranged by Merle Isaacs. Come back as a play, as a musical as well. So it's an American American.
Thank you.